Well, the equity markets have been cheering partly because the budget is a pro-growth budget, pro-capex budget, and the global markets have been supporting. But one market that's absolutely sulking is the bond market, totally rattled by the 14.3 lakh crore of government borrowing that will hit them starting April 1st. They were prepared for at best 12 lakh crore. So it's a good 15-20% higher than what the market was prepared for. And that's why you can see bond yields today rising to another high. I think it's 6.8789 today as we speak, all right? 6.9 is here on the old 10-year. The new 10-year is still probably at 6.8788. But there is a growth kicker in terms of capex. So to discuss both angles, I have with me Prasanna, Head Global Markets Group at ICICI Bank. Gentlemen, thank you very much indeed for joining us. Prasanna, you may have looked at the screen yourself, but I can tell you the bad news. It is 6.92 for the 6.1, the new 10-year bond, and the old 10-year bond is at 6.9. You tell me, I mean, as a bond dealer, what are the bond markets making of this number? Are they seeing any solace on the horizon? Especially because of secretaries are not giving any guarantee about the bond inclusion or inclusion of Indian bonds in the indexes.
Yeah. So thank you, Lata, for having me on the show. And so before I actually directly reply, I say that I kind of agree with everything that Samiran actually pointed out in terms of the budget being conservative and actually under accounting for the potential tax collections, both on non-tax as well as tax collections. Having said that, I think, see, Lata, before the budget itself, you should realize that the markets were actually, you know, kind of yields had gone up by nearly 50 basis points even before the budget, primarily due to macro factors like rising current account deficit, not to alarmist levels, but to much higher levels than what we have been used to in the last 2 years, rising global bond yields, increasingly hawkish global central bank, because of which there are lower flows into emerging markets, India also not getting enough flows, even on the equity side, and higher oil prices and prognosis for even higher oil prices as the geopolitical premium seems to be kicking in. Now, as we went into the budget, like I think you rightly mentioned, there were two expectations. One was that fiscal deficit was to be at around close to 6 to 6.3, depending upon which research house you spoke to. Gross borrowing program was 12.5 lakh crores. And then there was a rationalization of capital gains tax that was expected, which will pave the way for euro clearability, which in turn make the case indispensable for a bond index inclusion. Now, bond markets were actually not prepared for a disappointment on both these factors. They were okay with one of the two factors being a disappointment. But what we instead got was a borrowing program which was higher by around 2.5 lakh crores than what was expected, and the euro clearability, the tax thing are not really working out. So I think even if tax collections were to improve, the fear is that, like Samiran rightly pointed out, the budget would be, I mean, the government would rightly so use it up for spending. So it is a good news that the markets will gladly take, but at a later time. What we have to manage right now is what is going to happen over the next 1 or 2 months. And when you look at the higher borrowing program and look at the fact that there is unlikely to be an RBI buying and looks like there is not going to be a FPI buyer coming in due to bond index inclusion in the first half of next financial year, at best now we can hope for the next second half of the financial year. That's the reason why, you know, bond yields are going up. Not surprising that it has touched 690.91 in the morning today, 687 on the new one. We do expect the steepening theme to, you know, play out as the high government borrowing program targeted at the long end exerts upward pressure on yields. Obviously, if RBI were to show its cards either during the policy in terms of coming to the market to buy or in the next year by using open market operations, obviously, we'll have to look at a revised view. But right now, since RBI is about to commence on a rate hike cycle, the degrees of freedom for RBI is very, very limited. And one assumes that they will not be able to outright buy government bonds in the market. At best, what they could do is something like an operation twist. So that's where the expectations are.
Well, actually, they've done twists and switches aplenty. I don't know how much more elbow room they have. But Prasanna, just very quickly, government has got 5.5 trillion in terms of cash reserves. If some of the borrowings of February are cancelled, I mean, it's not much that is left, but if that is cancelled, can that be a good signal anything that can work for the bond bull, if there is one?
So that will be a step reaction, Lata. The day the auction cancellation happens and no new borrowing is, or no replacement borrowing is announced, bond yields will, there will be a step reduction in the bond yields. But having said that, that will be, I don't know whether that's a good news from a permanent nature. What can happen is it gets reset lower by 15 basis points or 10 basis points. And then the inevitable will have to happen when they start borrowing in April, because obviously the borrowing program next year is going to be onerous. And even if you assume that there is going to be a 2.5 lakh crore reduction in the borrowing, that will possibly come out in the second half of the financial year. And in the first half, they will possibly go with a calendar of 1435, which is announced. And in the first half, they'll probably borrow 55% to 57%. And the calendar which will come out will probably show you a borrowing program of 35,000 to 37,000 crores per week. So it's quite an onerous task for them to borrow that much. And like I said, what is RBI going to do is something that we all will have to wait and see.
Absolutely. They have fewer cards with them at this point in time. And I thought cancelling one bond, which is not in their hands, the issuer has to give them permission. But perhaps that looks like the only positive that can come at the current juncture. And even as we speak, old 10-year 6.94. New 10-year, 6.92. Yields are rising by the minute, as it were. And a very quick additional, you don't see this tax issue getting sorted out anytime soon, right? Second half of next year is about all.
No, Lata, I think the RBI and the government have been doing quite a bit to facilitate the bond index inclusion and the euro credibility, because based on feedback from investors. So I think they are working on it. I mean, I don't have any direct knowledge of it. But I would assume that, see, the index inclusion per se is a very graded kind of a timeline. I mean, you get the tax clearance first, then. So by the way, euro clearability is not a prerequisite for bond index inclusion. I think I did make this point earlier.
Yes.
I think the size of the index eligible debt as far as the FAR securities in India is concerned is so high, it's crossing $200 billion, that it's just a matter of time before the bond index inclusion happens. And euro clearability would have hastened the process, but now possibly they'll take that much a little bit more time to do it. Either which way, I do believe the government is working on it, the RBI is working on it. And what I meant in terms of second half is the actual inflows to start trickling in, because you have the inclusion announcement first, then the actual announcement date, actual inclusion date, and then you have the funds which are tracking starting to buy the bonds. So that's why I had mentioned that it would be kind of in the second half of this financial year.
Okay, so bond range 6.995, have we hit the high, or you think you're seeing 7 plus?
No, I think 675 or 670 to 7 would be the range for the time being. And I'm holding on to a 7% upper limit only because I would like to see what RBI does at that stage.
Okay.
And otherwise, I would say that if the foreign fund investment flow is going to be extended and RBI is unable to outright infuse liquidity by buying bonds, or limited to whatever extent because of the change in the cycle, it doesn't stop at 7, it will have to go. So how gradually does it go up is the question.
Oh,
so for the time being, a stop at 7, but I think we need to be prepared for higher levels.
Okay. Without RBI support, Samiran's note says 10-year is on the path to 6.25. At the moment, that market is not rocking, but the December trade deficit is, the January trade deficit is also $18 billion. So we could have a challenge in the external sector, but maybe that at a later date. We wrap up on Bazaar, not much time. Thank you very much, Prasanna. More lined up for you on Chartbusters.